So hello everyone, myself Advocate Gautam Harswal, associate with Dialyzy. Welcome to Dialyzy. Today I'm going to discuss with you a new business topic in this video. So let's start the discussion without any further delay. So today's discussion will be upon how to convert a proprietorship firm into a private limited company, right? So let's start the discussion without any further delay. In this video, if we talk about a sole proprietorship firm, basically it cannot get all benefits of operation as it grows, right? So there will be a need to convert the proprietorship firm into a private limited company. The conversion can bring in its wake all the benefits of a company, like higher capital limited liability and so on, right? And the another thing is, the conversion of a proprietorship firm into a private limited company provides many benefits, but it also brings along the diffusion of power and loss of independence. Therefore the decision must be taken after careful consideration of all the facts of all the factors involved, and see it is in it, right? So the another thing we're going to discuss is, what are the basic conditions for the conversion of proprietorship firm into a private limited company. So the very first condition we as a proprietorship firm must follow is a takeover agreement or a sale agreement needs to be entered into between the sole proprietor and the company. Then next one is the memorandum of association or MOA needs to carry the object, the takeover of a sole proprietorship. The third one is, all the assets and liabilities of the sole proprietorship must be transferred to the company. The fourth one is, the shareholding of the proprietorship should not be less than 50% of the voting power, and the same must continue to be held for a period of 5 years. The last one is, the proprietor does not receive any additional benefits either directly or indirectly, except to the extent of shares which are being held. The last one is procedure of for conversion of a proprietorship firm into a private limited company. The first procedure is, the procedure must complete the slump sale formalities. The next one is the director identification number or DIN and the digital signature certificate or DSC must be obtained for all the directors. The next one is the proprietorship, or the proprietor must apply for the availability of name in form 1. The next one is prepare the MOA and articles of association or AOA of the company, specifying the objects and the rules of the company. The next one is, apply for the incorporation of the company to the Ministry of Corporate Affairs or MCA. The next one is submit all the relevant documents and the next one is, receive the certificate of incorporation. The second last is to apply for a new PAN and TAN. And the last one is, modify the bank details as per the conversation, right? So that's all about our discussion. I hope you're pretty much clear with the thing we have discussed in this video. In case of any confusion, do let me know in the comment section. For more updates, stay tuned on Dialyzy. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.